All right, guys, we are back in my garage for another video, and I have a confession to make. My car isn't perfect. I know that might be a surprise to a lot of you, but I actually messed up the threads on my cylinder head when I reinstalled my valve cover one of the last times I pulled it. And so unfortunately, that means I need to repair the threads in my cylinder head. And this is relatively common, especially when you have aluminum components on your engine or your cylinder head. When you're tightening a bolt, it can go from righty-tighty to righty-loosey, and all of a sudden it turns a quick job into a much longer process. So I bought a kit from Amazon. I will of course have it linked in the video description, and it has the inserts that you can repair your threads so that not only will you not have that issue with stripped threads anymore, but it'll actually make it stronger than the standard aluminum thread would be. So let's go ahead and hop over to the car and I'll show you how to get this fixed. Now, as always, for everybody that's new to the channel, I create these videos to help keep you updated on the latest developments in our community, as well as discuss technical topics so that we have a better understanding of how our engines work. So if you're interested in more videos like that, be sure to subscribe because there will be a lot more coming out in the future. Alright guys, so here's the skinny. So we've got the valve cover off, and I can show you what's actually going on. So here you see we've got really nice threads. Really nice threads, really nice threads, and ooh, bottomless hole with threads barely down at the bottom. So this is what we're going to fix. We're going to repair the threads so that I can properly seal up my valve cover. Now that it's winter, we're finally going to get this fixed properly. So this is the kit that I bought. I will have a link to it in the video description for my Amazon store. And I really like this one for a couple different reasons. So one is, of course, it actually fixes the threads, but two, you've got a bunch of different sizes, which especially for our cars, they're all pretty much metric. So I got this metric kit, and whatever I run into, I should be able to fix it with this kit. And the way it works is we're going to drill out the hole, then we're going to re-thread it, and then we're going to take one of these little threaded inserts and thread that into the hole, and that's going to repair the hole so that we can thread the screw into this insert. So I'll show you how that works, but again, the process is pretty simple. You've got all the different sizes here. For this specific one on the valve cover, we're going to use the M6. So let's go ahead and show you how it's done. All right, so we get to do a voiceover since for some reason my microphone didn't record this part. But anyway, so as you can see right here, this area is very sensitive and we're getting ready to start drilling. So it was important to protect around the hole. So what I did was I put this tape triangle around the hole and then added additional shop towels to make sure that I don't get any shavings in the cylinder head. Now, if you're doing this outside of the engine somewhere, it's a lot less critical, but you are going to be drilling and getting metal shavings out of the hole, so you just want to make sure you protect it. So use the drill that is appropriately sized for the threads that you're going to be repairing, and then we're going to go ahead and start drilling into the hole. Just be careful and try to drill in as straight as possible and move really slowly so, again, you're not throwing metal shavings everywhere. So I did this by hand. I was able to get it in there pretty straight since the first half of this hole had no threads in it anyway. So it kind of allowed me to start it in a little bit. And then after it got started, I just turned the drill slowly. You can see all the metal shavings coming out. And then once it bottomed out, I reversed the threads and, you know, reverse drilled it back out. So now we've got metal shavings everywhere. What do you do? What I like to do is just use a shop rag. If it has a little bit of oil on it, that also kind of helps, but just kind of pat it down, and that makes sure that you get most of the bigger metal shavings. They'll just stick to the shop towel. So you can pat it, and then as you lift it up, you see all the shavings stuck to the towel, and that will get most of it off. So don't go crazy. Just be careful. If you wipe it off with a towel, you might push some shavings into the hole. So that's why I like to pat it. And then as you pick it up, the shavings will come with the towel. Now, the next thing that we want to do is actually tap the hole. And so again, the correct thread tap comes with the kit. So I've got that mounted into my tool. I think this might be the only thing that doesn't come with the kit, but I just got this from Home Depot. They probably have options on Amazon as well if you want to buy it all together. But this tap is going to cut the threads to fit the insert, so you can see all the sharp edges. This will bite into it and create new threads. Now you're going to want to use some kind of fluid. I highly recommend using cutting fluid. I don't have any on hand, so I'm just going to use some WD-40. Now the benefit of using cutting oil is it's a little bit thicker and kind of sticky, so as you're threading your bit into the hole, it's going to pick up all the metal shavings and stuff and just make it more likely to kind of self-clean itself, if you will. But since we have WD-40 on hand, that's what we're going to use. So spray a little bit on the bit. Spray a little bit in the hole. And then we are going to start tapping. So just kind of melt it in here, just like before. Make sure you're going in as straight as possible. And then just start to turn. And it should go in pretty easily, but if it starts kind of getting tight, you can back up a little bit and then start going in again. And that just kind of helps clean it out. Seems to be working pretty well. There we go, and I think I've bottomed out. So once you hit the bottom, then we'll just back it all the way off. And you can see a lot of the metal shavings are coming out, so that's what we like to see. There we go. So yeah, just be careful with those. Make sure you're not getting them in your cylinder head. Lots of good stuff. So even with the WD-40, it stuck to it pretty good. And then we'll just go back with our shop rag again and pat it. And it picks up some of it. Some is being a little more stubborn, but basically wipe it off. If you put a little bit of oil or something on here, that'll also help it stick. And I'm going to use a little bit of compressed air just to make sure I blow it all out. And now the last step is to install the insert. So here's what it looks like. And you're going to take the appropriately sized tool. And you see how it has this little cutout right there? That goes through this little piece of wire that's going through the middle. So you kind of put it on here and then rotate it until the wire lines up with the cutout and then goes all the way in. So now you've got it on here and we can thread it into the threaded hole. There we go. And look at that. So now it looks just like the others with nice clean threads. Now you still do have that metal piece down in there. And what you're supposed to do is kind of punch that out. So you have a little tool that rests in the hole. You hit it with a hammer and it breaks off the little end piece. I don't think that's always needed. I've honestly never understood why that's required if it's not a through hole, but it's recommended to do that. So here's the tool that you use to punch off the tang. Again, there's a specific one for each size insert, so make sure you're using the right one. And then you drop it through this hole, and then you hit it with a hammer. And just like that, it's broken off. Now at this point, we're going to go ahead and roll up all of the shop towels as carefully as possible. Again, just making sure you don't get any metal into the sensitive components. just kind of pull it away so it effectively scoops up any last little bits. So that way you're not letting it get into the engine. Beautiful. And you'd never know the difference, right? Looks just how we started. So, very good. So yeah, honestly, pretty straightforward. Once I reinstalled my valve cover, I had no more issues. And I'm really happy to have this kit because, again, just having it on standby, I am able to repair any threads that I have issues with. I know that I have multiple sizes, and it's just really convenient to have it in case the worst were to happen. So again, my Amazon link is in the video description. And as always, if you guys shop with me, it does help support the channel so I can make more videos like this in the future. And otherwise, I think that's it for this video. So thank you guys for watching, and I hope this helps. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below.